Dubai'den herkese merhaba. Ben Mahmut Karsoğlu. Bugün sizlere Dubai'den sesleniyorum. Arkamda da görebildiğiniz gibi Microsoft'un Dubai ofisinin hemen önündeyiz. Microsoft bugün burada Trust and Security etkinliğini düzenliyor. Özellikle MEA bölgesinde, Türkiye'nin de içinde olduğu MEA bölgesinde en son siber tehditleri, bunlara karşı neler yapmamız gerektiğini ve aynı zamanda Microsoft'un bu konuda neler yaptığını bizlere anlatacaklar. Şimdi istiyorsanız içeri geçelim ve etkinliği yerinde takip edelim. Şu an Microsoft'un Dubai ofisindeyiz. Yanımızda David Weston var, Red Team'in kurucusu. Kendisine birkaç tane sorumuz olacak. Red Team neler yapıyor, nasıl kuruldu?
The Red Team was built over a number of years, in the last 3 or 4 years. And the reason we built it is we were having good results with mitigating attacks that were coming from either customers or from the community. But that was a very reactive approach. We wanted to go proactive and start fixing some of the things before they impacted folks. So we got the idea to take what we learned from attackers and build our own internal attack team. I think we have embraced getting better, which means rather than just assuming what we produce is always going to be strong or perfect, the Red Team has been able to show us that there's constantly room for improvement. And just when we think we've got it figured out, we probably don't. So it's helped build a healthy culture of evolution and the need to get better with respect to security. Yeah. That's always a tricky challenge. There's a lot more projects that need Red Teaming than there are Red Team members. And so we use a number of things. Priority for the customer. Is this used in critical infrastructure? New products get priority because we'd like them to be tested before they hit to customers. And sometimes we just select projects because the members of the team are really fascinated. And I think it's important to have a culture of creativity and curiosity. Yeah. Well, I think, you know, the first part of the selection is we select folks who are sort of known to be collaborating with security companies in a way that's been healthy and productive. That's first of all, and that sort of eliminates anybody who might have nefarious objectives. And then number two, we select folks based on the quality of their research that's already in the public domain. So a lot of times we're going to security conferences or industry events, identifying talent and then working to convince them Microsoft's a good place to apply their trade. Yeah, absolutely. I think machine learning and AI are a great tool in the toolbox, particularly when it comes to the detection and prevention of attacks. So machine learning really helps to scale out human expertise into operating on data that we couldn't just have enough humans look at. So that's incredibly helpful. I think another stage is working with our hardware partners to evolve the CPU, chipsets, video cards, all of the components of the machine to have additional security features that we can take advantage of that will really help stop attacks. There's a couple of tips I have. The first is get on the latest version of Windows. Red Team and other folks are constantly helping to add new protection innovations, and that's almost always going to be in the newest version of the operating system. So it's really critical to get on that latest version. Number two is once you're on the latest version, stay up to date. The vast majority of attacks we see actually come from unpatched machines, so they're vulnerabilities that could have been prevented. And the third thing is identity is frequently targeted by attackers. So things like phishing attacks where someone's convincing you to use type in your username or password, that can be mitigated by using technologies like biometrics, such as Windows Hello, or using multi-factor authentications like Authenticator mobile apps or SMS.
Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you.
Chip TV'den David Weston'la gerçekleştirdiğimiz röportajımızın sonuna geldik. Bir başka röportajımızda görüşmek üzere. Hoşça kalın. Chip TV'nin YouTube kanalını abone olmayı ve takip etmeyi unutmayın.